and welcome to another Scriptcase Macros course video. Today we're going to be looking at the SE Ajax JavaScript macro. My name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the instructor leading this course. So this macro here executes JavaScript methods from Ajax events in Scriptcase. So here's the documentation for it here. So basically, let me go ahead and find it here. There it is, SE Ajax JavaScript in the control section, and I click on it, and here it is. So you can call it in some events on the form, control and calendar applications. There's a scope down below, but you first need to define a JavaScript method in the programming setting. So we're going to show you how to do that here in just a second. And then you just pass through that method name and then an array of parameters if those are needed. So the second option is optional if you don't have any parameters. And here's some examples of how to use it. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to use one of these, kind of copy it, but here's the scope of where it can be executed. So let's go over to Scriptcase now and do this. So I have a control application set up here, and there's just two fields, two number fields, and we're going to write a method to add these two together. So let me run it so I can show you what it looks like. So it's just two number fields, pretty simple control form here. So now let's create a JavaScript method. So that's the first step we need to do. If you go back here to the documentation, you need to define a method there. So we're going to go to programming, JavaScript methods right here, and then new method. And we need to give the method a name, so I'm going to call it addNums. We're going to add two numbers together, and then click create on that. So this is where we can put the code for our method, but we first need to define some parameters so we can test that. So as you can see, you can pass some parameters in here that way, so I'm going to show you how to do that. So you need to click up here, this function button here, the F and the X in parentheses, and here's the parentheses. Here's the parameters. So two parameters here, click add, and then I'm going to name them. So they're going to be parm A and parm B, just like so, and then hit save on that. So there they are, add nums with parm A and parm B, just like you would expect in a typical function definition. So now we just need to add these together. So I'm going to create a variable called sum and then plus parm a. So that's just converting the parameter into a integer, and then plus parm b. So those addition signs are just converting the string into an integer, so it doesn't concatenate it together as a string. It adds it as numbers, and then alert sum. So I'm just going to pop an alert with that sum in there. This is a very simple function, nothing too complicated, but enough to show you how this works. So let's hit save on that. And now we need to create an Ajax event. So we're going to do that over here under Ajax events on the left, and then new Ajax event. And then we need to select the field the event is going to be executed on. So num2 is going to be the field. And then the event that it's going to be, I'm going to do on blur. So that's when we click out of it. And I'm going to pass through both fields as parameters for that. So there we go, and here is our place to put some PHP code so we can call this JavaScript method. So let's go ahead and copy this last example here, and that'll get us almost all the way there. So I'm going to copy them and paste it in here. So the first element is our method name, which is addNums, so I'm going to put that in there. So that's the method we're calling. And then the second element is an array of the parameters. So I'm going to pass through the two fields. So the text is actually correct already. I just need to put it in the curly braces since it is a field variable, just like so. So passing through num1 and num2 from those fields, so that's the field values there. And then we're all set up and we can go ahead and run this. So now when we click out of the num2 field, we should get an alert with the sum. So I'm going to enter a number in the first number and then in the second number. So I'm going to enter 1 and then 2. So we should get an alert of 3. And there we go. So it pops up an alert with 3 right like that. So that's how you use the SE Ajax JavaScript macro to execute a JavaScript method from an Ajax event in Scriptcase.